Good afternoon and welcome back. I'm playing with MDT again, and I'm looking at creating my security updates folders and importing the security updates. I did have a script that did this before, but it required me to put the month name in for the security updates. With a little bit of playing, MDT is able to do this for you. Let's just have a look. I've got one of my monthly update ISOs in, which are available from Microsoft. And if we go through and have a look at the volume name contains the date, July 2011 in this case. So really there's no need for me to put in a date. I've just got to be able to read with WMI the volume name from my DVD. So let's look at how that is done. If I just go out to PowerShell and we'll have a look at a script. I just go and run the script volume name. We can see that we're reading out now correctly 0711. Let's take a look inside this script. So let's just navigate through to the E drive to scripts and then take a look. If I choose open with and then notepad, so the first thing, we're creating and populating a variable called month. We then use WMI and look for the Win32 logical disk. The nice thing is about WMI, it's pretty much the same no matter what you're looking at it, whether it's with C#, VBS, in this case PowerShell. So it's always going to be Win32 underscore logical disk because that's part of the WMI database. And then we want to search for only drives of type 5, which is the DVD CD-ROM removable drive type. And then repopulate it with the volume name property and repopulate the variable again. This time we're going to the substring, we're returning from the fourth character, and then we want four characters. So we're missing out the DLC underscore and returning 0711. And then, as we saw, we were just writing it back so we could see that that picked it up correctly. Adding this into my packages script, so here's the script where we import packages. We can see then we just add those lines in as we had them before. The rest of this then is pretty much the script working as the way it was before. We're importing our Windows 7 64-bit packages and we're importing them then to packages security updates Windows 7 dollar platform, in this case being x64, and we're creating a new item, a new folder based on the month variable. So the whole thing of this is just making life far more easy for me and reliably correct. Let's just jump out of this, have a look then at importing from the disk. We can go import packages. If I just change the DVD now and put in another DVD, so now we have the August DVD in. If we run through the script again, so with that in place, let's have a look at what it's done for me in the deployment toolkit. So I go into my deployment workbench. Let's go through now and refresh. So we've got July's updates, August's updates, and these are all the 64-bit updates. Jump down and refresh. So again, under the 32-bit, the x86. And then again, all of these are the x86. So you can see why it's so important to invest a little bit of time in PowerShell, because tasks like this would have taken me ages to import each one of these packages. We can see here we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So, and there were 3 from July. So it would be 26 packages that I would have to create. So yeah, why would you do it manually? Hope you found this fun, and we'll look forward to seeing you back soon. Thank you.